Hey, what's up? This is Jamal Abbott here to give you a quick rundown of the 8x8 video meetings platform. So as you know, especially with you looking at this video, there's been a lot of excitement and a lot of video products that are out there in the market for you to use for your conferencing, whether you're currently sheltered in place because of COVID-19, or maybe you're just looking for a video platform for your organization or for your family. Either one of those cases, this is a great tool to use and something that I'm personally using for my Toastmasters meetings as well as other conferences. So it's really basic. As you can see, once you move the screen, you're presented with a number of controls down here at the bottom. And what I like about this, it's pretty clean, it's not too crowded, and it's pretty self-explanatory as to what you're getting yourself into. So starting down here at the very bottom, this is an option here to share your screen. Now, if you're in a meeting and you're presenting on a topic, this is what you'll need here to actually share your screen. So I'll go ahead and click this, and then you should see a pop-up here that shows you two screens, at least on my end. I have a screen here for the top part, and there's another screen for another monitor connected. If I want to share the screen, I can do that here, or I can go to this application window where I can go to individual applications that I want to share on my screen. Now, the next option here, we have this little hand. So if you're in the middle of a conference, you don't want to really want to interrupt somebody. It's kind of rude, and you don't want to cut off the speaker in mid-sentence. One way to get the speaker's attention is by clicking this hand icon, and this would send a notification to the panel that you have a question, and it's a less intrusive way to get your question asked or maybe to add some context to the discussion. So I like it. It works pretty well, and it's a nice feature to have in your meetings. This next option here is the chat. So if you're in the middle of a meeting, maybe there's some specific notes or some specific items that you need to share with the group, but you don't necessarily want to blurt that out in the middle of a conversation, you can use this chat here and provide some context to the discussion. So I'm going to set that out there, and then you can see the timestamp of when this particular chat was sent. And then if you have multiple participants here, you'll see the context of the chat in this section here. This CC here is to start and stop subtitles. If I go ahead and click this, I'll get a notification up here saying that this is being transcribed. And then at the bottom of this screen, you can see everything that I'm saying at this point. Once the meeting is done, you'll have a copy of this transcript to review, and then you can highlight any keywords or anything important from either one or many of the speakers that are present in your meeting. At the very bottom here, you have three meeting control buttons. We have the microphone, we have this phone to actually leave the meeting, and the video camera. So if any one of these two elements are highlighted in white below, that means it's on and active. And if I wanted to turn it off, I simply click here, and then the meeting goes away. Excuse me, the video goes away, and now you just see a silhouette of myself talking, letting the people know that I'm actively speaking and engaged in discussion. So if I want to turn this back on, I simply go down here and click where it's currently crossed off, click this icon, and it brings the video back up on the screen. So the same thing with the microphone, I can click this to turn it off. Now you can hear me. And you saw that little pop-up on the bottom basically saying, hey, are you trying to say something? You're muted. Good indication that you're muted and that you need to turn that back on so you can be heard by the participants in the meeting. Here we have the toggle view, and if you click this, you're able to toggle the view, and then you have like multiple participant view of your meeting. So it's just me right now, so there's not a whole lot of toggling here. But if you look at this next screenshot, you actually see there's a list of participants, and then we are in a kind of like a Brady Bunch type of format where we're all stacked up with one another. So that's pretty cool. All right, so this next section here for inviting people, if you click this, it's going to ask you to search for people and add their numbers. This is a part of the 8x8 virtual office suite. So I have one contact that I'm going to bring up here, and this is for Anita. So if I want to invite her to this meeting, I simply click on her name and she'll get a meeting invite asking her to join and to participate in this meeting. We won't do that here today because Anita is currently unavailable. This icon right here, this is for your information on the meeting. You can see here that here's the link to the meeting. Here's the dial-in information. So if I wanted to join in as an audio participant and maybe not participate on the video, I can dial this from any mobile or landline phone and enter in this PIN to get in. Another important thing here too is that there might be some additional dial-in numbers. And then with these dial-in numbers, I'll go ahead and bring this screen here to the front. You can see that you can actually be reached by any one of these dial-in numbers from the United States or from other parts of the world. There's toll-free options too, so there's no cost to the individual to join this meeting. Going back to the share icon, if I want to just copy this link here, I go ahead and click this copy button, and I can take it here to a notepad and then bring that here to this screen. Now, if I wanted to copy all of the information for the meeting, let's just say for an example, I can click this information icon, click the copy button, and then now come back here and then have all this information for the meeting. So in addition to having the meeting link, I have the information for dialing in as well as the passcode and then some other options to participate and join in the meeting. So pretty neat, I think. And then finally, this is going to differ depending upon what version of 8x8 video meetings you're using. I am a paid version, and this is a part of the virtual office suite. So there's an option here for recording. If you're using this as a standalone user and then you haven't registered for an account, no worries. You just won't be able to record these meetings or keep track of previous meeting history if you choose that option. So it all depends on your needs. If you want the ability to record meetings, have your own personal meeting space, or maybe even integrate this with your own calendar application, then it's beneficial for you to sign up for a free account, and that gives you all those features and benefits that I just described. But certainly not mandatory to sign up and to participate and use this software. So these three dots give you more information about how to manage the meeting itself. So you can manage the video quality, you can start a live stream, you can start the recording. I'll bring up here the settings because this is pretty important. If you're having some problems with the microphone itself, this is a good way to see if you're actually using the right microphone or if you're even using the right camera for your setup. So you can click the options here and then you can choose the appropriate devices. And finally, you can see some more information about the meeting statistics. So this is more of kind of like a geeky view, but you can see the packet loss, the bit rate, and then what's going on with this connection. So there's a lot of good information here if you're into that kind of stuff when it comes to stats and video conferencing quality. That's there for you. And then bringing this here back up towards the top, this is the actual name of the conference. And then if there is more than one user, you would actually see an icon showing the number of participants in this meeting. But it's just me for now, so this is all that's in here. And then you can see how long this meeting has been going on. So that's pretty much it. It's pretty straightforward. I hope this was informative and it gives you an idea of the interface that you're working with. So 8x8 video meetings is completely free, available at 8x8.vc. You can sign up and register for your own meeting and then get all those benefits that I had just described. Or if you just want to try this out for yourself and then not commit to anything, you're certainly more than welcome to start a meeting, come up with a custom name, and then use it and then be done with it and not have to worry about that information being out there on the internet forever and ever. So this is Jamal Abbott. Thanks for tuning in. If you have any questions, let me know. I'll talk to you soon.